Welcome back. The last video session, until the last video session, we have completed the how to create a RESTful Web Services in using Spring Boot. As part of that, we have implemented various endpoints: get mapping, post mapping, put mapping, delete mapping. Now, these examples are showed using the list object. I have not used a database. Instead, I use a list object. Using the list object, I showed crude operation: how to create, how to add a object, how to delete, how to remove, how to update the object. Now we are going to convert this RESTful Web Services using H2 database. H2 database is a in-memory database that provided in-memory database. We can use this database only for testing purpose. We cannot use this database for real time. Okay, whenever Spring Boot run, the H2 database will be available. We can add product, delete product, view product. We can do all crude operations. After stopping the server, database data disappear. The database data vanished. Okay, let's see. Now, if you want to create a, if you want to interact with database, what you have to do, we have to implement JPA. We have to implement a JPA. Spring Boot uses several projects, right? For example, let's say in our pom.xml, if you open a pom.xml, you can see here Spring Boot started web. Spring Boot started web means you using this particular dependency, you can create a web application, you can create a RESTful web service application. If you want to interact with the database, there is another starter project called Spring Data, Spring Boot starter data. We have to use that starter data. I'm taking latest one. Copy that, just place here. Once you add this particular starter project, Spring Boot starter data JPA, once you added this, remove the version. Once you added that, your application capable to handling DB operations with any database. Okay, in this example, we are going to use H2 in memory database. For that, we need to add one more dependency: H2 database artifact. Copy that, add that too. You don't have to mention test system, you don't have to mention version. Just you put the dependency, the version managed by your Spring Boot dependencies, that will automatically take the correct version. Okay, so you don't have to worry about the version. Now I added Spring Boot starter data JPA. Then, since I want to connect with MySQL database, connect with H2 InMap database, I am using these dependencies. Okay, now we have to create, now we have to configure database. Just to copy this and put this here. The database URL, your H2 database by default provide this testdb, automatically that provided by testdb. The driver name, org H2 driver, username is a SCA, password is a nothing, password is a empty, by default password is a empty. Then dialect is a H2 dialect. This tell to the JPA which database you are using. If you are going to use MySQL, we need to use MySQL dialect. If you are going to say SQL Server, you need to say SQL Server dialect. Through this property, your Spring Boot JPA knows which database you are going to connect. According to this, for example, If you are going to use H2 dialect, if you are going to use MySQL, if you are going to use SQL Server dialect, whatever dialect you are using, according to that database, your JPA generate the SQL query. According to the dialect, your JPA generate the SQL query. So, you don't have to worry about the data migration. For example, today I am going to use MySQL. Tomorrow I can use any other database. That time you just change the dialect. You don't have to worry about any SQL queries. Automatically that taken care by your JPA. That is the purpose of dialect. Okay, now I added the configuration for H2 database. Here spring jpa.showsql. Whenever I am performing CRUD operation, that is create means adding something, or means read, crude operation, that is crud, crude. Let's say I'll comment. Ash symbol is a comment out, comment section. C means create, R means read, U means update, D means delete. Okay. Whenever do the crude operation, so let's say C create. Whenever insert some insert data through our Spring Boot application, that insert query generated by JPA, I want to see that insert query log. So if you want to see that particular query statement, we need to use this particular property. Okay, if it is true, whatever code operation you are performing through your Spring Boot application, that respective query will display in your log. That is the purpose of this particular property. Spring H2 console enabled equal true, that meaning you can browse your database through the user interface. Spring framework provide user interface. Through that user interface, we can browse the database that we are inserting in the H2 database. Through this property, we can enable a user interface to see the data in a H2 database. Okay, this is a configuration for a H2 DB. Now I want to create one model, right? Model we have already created. What you have to do is we need to map this particular model in the product table available in the H2 database. Okay, here our database name is testdb. Whenever start application, I want to create one product table. That product table column should be whatever attribute available in the product class. Okay, for that we need to say at entity, at entity. Why it's not coming? I added, right? I added, but entity and is not recognized. If give like this problem, better do like this. Right click pom.xml file, map and re-import. Sometime this whatever library downloads through this artifact, the library is not downloaded properly sometimes. That is the reason. Yeah, the entity annotation is not coming here. To resolve that issue, better you can do go to Maven and re-import. Say re-import, it's going to download all the libraries and build it automatically. Now I can say at entity. Okay, at entity. Now at table. At table name equal to product. I prefer all database table name should be capital letters, so I am giving product. Now I want to map the each attribute to in our database table. This is primary key, so I want to add ID attribute at ID. Sorry, ID. At ID. I did some wrong at ID. Okay, ID. Okay. Then I want to tell to JPA this column should be auto increment. Okay. For that, at generated value what is the generated value? I forgot the syntax. Let's see what is the syntax of this generated value. Yeah, this is the syntax. Okay, now this product ID equivalent column will be added to the database. That column act as a auto increment. Now I want to map each column like this. A column name equal to product name. Copy this. Product price. Then product stock count. That's it. We have mapped. Now we have mapped our model attribute, that is entity object. That we generally we can say entity object. This entity object we are mapped with our database column. Now whenever start this application, what will happen? JPA will read this class and create the table in the testdb. The testdb is going to create the table name called product. That product table should have a following column. Now we'll go to restart and check. Okay. Run. See here, H2 console available at. Since we are given this property, right? Spring.h2.console enabled equal true, it's available. The H2 console available at /h2 console. If we say like this, we can see the H2 console. Okay, now our DB configuration successfully happened. There is no error. Okay. Yeah, I'm going to see the database now. http://localhost, it's a 9080 /h2 console. You see h2 console, it will open this particular user interface. As I mentioned, the username is a default username SA, password is empty. Okay, connect. It's connected now. See, the product table already created. Instead of product table, product ID, product name, product price, product stock count. As of now, there is no. When you click here, there is a SQL statement coming here. When you say run, it will run. There is no product now. Okay, now we have completed with the DB configuration. We are able to connect the database. We are able to see the H2 console. Next step is through our JPA program, through our REST services, we want to add a product, update a product, delete a product, this DBO product, this operation we are going to see. Okay. Now what we can do, go to the controller. Okay, before going to the controller, I want to create one repository class. I want to create one more package. Package name is repository. This repository package should contain all my DOA classes, that is database classes. These classes interact with the database, do the DMN operation. I mean, they do the CRUD operation. Now I want to create one repository interface which is do the CRUD operation against product table. So my product is this, copy this name, then right click new class product, then followed by repository. This is a mandatory, okay? Product followed by repository have to mention. Then this should be an interface. Okay, then this class should extend with crude repository. Crude repository, okay. Now I can say long slash product. Sorry, we have to say product slash long. Product slash, sorry, comma, long. Okay, now if you define the interface like this, through this particular interface, you can create a, we can perform a crude operation without writing in a single line of a code. Okay, you don't have to write any code for add, delete, update, modify. You don't have to do anything, everything available inside the product repository itself. When you click this crude repository, you can see here, save, find by ID, find all, delete. The save will do both add and update. Okay, so all methods are already available here, so you don't have to write any methods. Just you need to use this class to access this method in your service class. Now I added a database layer. This is a database layer I've added, which is performed the crude operation. Now I want to add a service class. When you look at the controller class here, I have added all them by business logic. Adding a business logic in controller class is not advisable. We should not implement our business logic in the controller class. All business logic should move in a service class. Service class should have a business logic. After performing a particular business, it called the database. It called the database, do the crude operation. Okay, now we're going to create a service package. Now I'm going to get a service package. I have created a service package. Under that service package, I created one class called product service. This product service annotated with add service annotation. I have already explained about these annotations. Please check my previous video. Now this class acts as a service class. Okay. Now I want to perform a crude operation through this product service class. For that, I need to declare product repository class, which I created already. Using AutoWire, I am declaring a product repository. Then I want to add a method for adding a new product. Public product save product. Product repository dot save this product. That's it. We save the return a newly ordered product, so I am returning that. Whenever you interact with database, for example, this save product calling the product repository, that meaning through this repository class you're interacting with the database and performing a DB operation, which is inserting some product data in the database. So you're doing some transaction. Whenever you perform some DB operation, that particular method should annotated with a transactional. Okay, this is mandatory. Since my save product interacting with database, I am annotating this method with add transactional. Now I want to get a product. I want to view a particular product. For that, this copy this method. Get product, then long product ID. Here, repository class having method called find by ID product ID. Now this is returning an error. Why this is returning an error? When you look at the find by ID, this return optional of T. Optional is a Java 8 feature. This optional class act as a container class. This class enclosed with a particular class. Here T is representation of, it's a class, any class. Using this optional class, we can handle null pointer exception. For example, whenever a class return null value, whenever the particular method return null value, for example, find by id returns null value, instead of returning null value to the call to the caller place, I can do something. Let's see here. For example, here what I am doing here, repository dot find by id, I am passing this product id. If the product id matches with database, this return product. Otherwise, I want to return empty product. Otherwise, I want to return empty product. Instead of returning a null value, I want to return empty product if product is does not exist in the database. Still, if you don't understand this line, I'll give you more clarity now. See here, find by id gives optional of particular t. That meaning, I remove this line itself, okay. Say optional of product optional equal to product repository dot find by id of product id I am passing. Now when pass this product id, the find by id go to the database. If the product matches with this id, return a product, that product enclosed with optional class. So I am returning that. Now my product, that is our product, enclosed with the optional class. Now I want to get the product from optional class. For that, product equal to product optional dot or else new product. That meaning, from the optional container class, I'm calling one method called or else. That meaning, if the product having a null, that means that is find by id return null object, I want to create a new empty product assigned to here. Otherwise, this will return a product object. If the product id matches its database, this will give the product and assign to the product object. If product does not have in the database, I am creating a new product assigning to empty product here. That's it. Okay. Through this, we can avoid the null pointer exception. In the caller place, we can avoid the null pointer exception. Through this optional method, never give null. If the product is exist, return the actual product. If not exist, return the empty product. Now we have implemented two methods. One is the add or update method. Another one is getting a particular product. Through save method, we can perform add as well as update. Okay. I hope you understand whatever I have covered now. I will stop this video now. We'll going to continue rest of the session in next video. Okay. Please subscribe if you are not yet. Share this video to your friend circle. Click bell icon for regular updates. Thank you so much for watching this full video. Until next video, bye bye from Suresh K7.